You're constantly making node structures over and over again for the same things in different comps. What you might actually need. Welcome to an ongoing series on my channel where I try to teach you something about DaVinci Resolve as fast as I can. To start us off, we're going to do baby's first node. This one is probably the easiest for you to understand and for you to kind of understand how to do what we have to do. You may have experience in DaVinci Resolve, and if you do, that's great. But you might have noticed there's no way to get opacity in the node structures. There's no way to just have a node that just does opacity. Or in my case, I also have this node that also allows you to do masking. So, how do you get this tool? Well, you do know that in merge nodes, you have the blend tool, and then the dissolve node, if you have a background with an empty alpha channel, can obviously dissolve between those two. But there is a much easier way. All you have to do is add a brightness and contrast node, and then enable alpha channel, and then right there, our gain is now our alpha. If you go beyond one, it kind of does some weird stuff, but we will actually make that not happen anymore when we export this macro. All we have to do now is right click it, come up here and create macro. So select gain, and we can then change gain's name to opacity. If we also want to have the masking options, come down here to common, enable apply mask inverted and multiply by mask. But then you also want to make sure that you have effect mask. That's going to actually give you that extra input to give you that mask input. Let's change the name to opacity, and then we can come up here and save as group or save as. We'll just do save as, but since this is just one node, it doesn't matter too much. You can put it in your macros folder here. It's going to be the default location. I'm going to call this opacity 2 since I already have one. So we're just going to press save and close out of that now, and we can also now delete our brightness contrast. If we then do space shift again and type in opacity, we'll have my node and then the one we just created, and we can see it is really nice. But you may notice we still can go past one. Let's actually fix that real quick. Let's reset that back to one, right click, macro, and then we're gonna actually find our macro down here. This is gonna allow us to edit the controls on it. And then we can come into here. This is the maximum number that you're able to put the slider to. You can always put a number in and go past that, but we can come into here and make this just one. And now if we were to come up here and save, and then we can see our maximum is one. Sometimes you have a control that won't do everything that you want it to do. And since we can actually do multiple nodes in one custom node, it makes it a little more difficult if you want to have one control a bunch of different things at the same time. For example, what if we want to have a chroma splitter and we want to have one XY coordinate control all of the different offsets, but they all go in different directions? How might we do that? Well, it's actually pretty easy. Let me show you. So to make the chroma splitter effect, all we have to do is have our icon or have our image selected or video selected. We're going to create a pipe router by alt clicking, and that is just going to make sure that our macro only has one input to make sure it's way easier to use later on. But then all we have to do is add a bunch of booleans. So if you type in B-O-O-L and do channel booleans, not the three bool, but the just bool. And then we need to add three of these. And let's connect up our points to each of these inputs. And then for each of these, we want to have just one of our channels enabled. For this one, we actually want it to be red, so we'll keep it as that. We will then come down here and select black and select black for blue. And even for alpha, we're gonna select black. We want to then just keep it at copy and then do that for the rest of these, but keeping the, each different channel open. Okay, there we go. Now, if we were to preview this, we can see we have just the red, green, and the blue channels. You will also see that we have the alpha going on here. That'll be somewhat fixed in a second, but we're gonna have that problem still going forward. If you know a solution to that, please let me know, because I'm actually been looking for that. Add another two channel booleans, one to combine the top two and then one to combine the bottom two. So we'll just pump this into there, and we can just release and drag or click and drag over the node and then just release and it goes to the right spot. Then we can connect this one to here and connect this into there. And this top one, we want to have it so that red and green are happening, but blue is black and so is alpha. And then we want to instead do add. If we were to preview this, we can see it is yellow because we're combining that red and green. We can come down here and we just can have them all as that. And we can switch it to add, and there we go. We have all of our colors back. And then if we want to also have the original video or icon being viewed over it, we can just bring this pipe over to the front and then release it. This will put that over the RGB values so that we still have that solid color. Come into here, move our pipe router back, and we would just want to add some transform nodes to each of these different channels. Pretty easy. Now let's actually make all those controls combined. So we're going to do a slightly more complex method, but you may not fully understand how expressions work for the XY coordinates. So I actually want to show you how to do the point controls as well. which includes like center, pivot, stuff like that. So let's keep transform one center just the same, but we will actually pin that with this little pin icon up here. And we'll actually view the other ones and we'll add expressions to these other two. We then want to highlight the first point on transform two. Come on down here and drop it over the center X of transform one. That'll give you the correct name of it. We can just type in dot X now. And that actually gives you this first point. So if we were to release and move that around, we can see now they are exactly linked, which is great, but let's do a little bit more with it. So what I want to do is actually negate the transform X on this one, but then also add one. So it's always like in a positive value. So it's not just going completely the opposite, but it's still kind of like going in the opposite direction. So there we go. Now, if you were to move this left, it should move the other one right. And there we go. Now we have green and red splitting just as we want. Pretty nice. And then we can keep the Y the same, but on transform three, let's go ahead and make both the X and Y different. So let's go into the same thing. We can do that and dot X. So we're gonna make this first one the exact same as we did on the green, but we're also then going to take the same name here, and we're actually going to put the X in the spot of the Y. That way we can have it going in an opposite of up and down, along with going in the opposite direction of side to side. So if we now move the X on transform one to the left, we can see we get an interesting splitting effect happening. You can obviously make this however custom you want, but this is what we're just gonna do for this video. There we go, we have our one control to rule them all. Let's go ahead and unpin this and select all of our nodes we want to actually have included. And we want to select the nodes in order of appearance. So since we only are really gonna ever control X, the transform one, we just wanna select transform one and then do a control and click on all the other nodes, including the pipe router. Go ahead and right click on any of the nodes now and do our same thing from before, create macro, and let's just add center, and we will just name this chroma offset. And since we don't need to have anything else really being enabled, we can just make sure, okay, this is definitely doing output for merge one, and this is definitely doing input for pipe router. Sounds good. We can do chroma splitter and press save as. We can even do save as group for this one to give you an example. I already have one being called chroma splitter, so I'll just call it chroma splitter splitter two, just so I have some difference. You can do really anything with these, selecting any of the controls that you'd really imagine. It is up to you. There's obviously more complex topics and I want to explore that in future videos. If you want to see more of that, let me know down in the comments. If you have any questions, also ask me down there. But if you want to talk more about this stuff, check out my Discord down in the description. But if you're still brand new and still don't know all the Fusion nodes, check out my video right here where I explain a lot more about the nodes, help you along your journey of actually growing in Fusion. Fusion's a scary place and I want you to feel like you're welcome. So happy animating.